Welcome to OPENBOX Education. In this video, I'm going to explain about HighPass filter Matlab code. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share to your friends. So here it is the Matlab code which defines that the frequency domain HighPass filter. So already we know that these instructions CLC, clear all and close all. So which are used to clear the command window and clear the previous values, and it will close that all the values. So here A equal to IM read of dot JPG picture. So that is nothing but this IM read which is used to read the image, and this as defined as A. So here this A of size which is taken as M comma N. So here which is represented M N in the brackets, that equal to size of the A. That is nothing but this M and N representing that row and column of this image A. Now we will define the mask for this HighPass filter. So here we'll take that mask equal to ones of M comma N. That is the size of the mask is same as the size of the image. So now we have to define the mask for this HighPass filter. So here if you see this one, this is the HighPass filter mask. So all the values about here are 1, and here we have that the mask where we have the value is equal to 0. So and remaining places we have the mask value is equal to 1, that is nothing but white, and here we have the black area is there. So here we have the value of 0 is there, that is the pixel value here it is 0. So like this we have to define that HighPass filtered mask. So for this one here we'll take that mask equal to ones of M comma N. So same as the size of A, that is the image A, here we have to take that the complete mask as ones, and we have to define the mask area at this place as zeros. So for this one here we are taking that for I equal to 150 to 180 and for J equal to 210 to 240 the mask of IJ equal to 0. That is here at this area the mask value becomes to 0, and remaining all the places we have the value is the pixel value is 1. So like this we will define that mask, and after that we'll go for C equal to fast Fourier transform for the two dimensional of the image A, and after that we'll go for that fast Fourier transform shift to this mask. So when you are shifting the mask, so here you'll get that like this. So after shifting that, after doing the fast Fourier transform and shift operation, here this HighPass filter mask will becomes to like this. And after that we'll simply multiply this fast Fourier transform of image A C into D. So here when you're using this E equal to C dot star D, then the mask will be multiplied element by element, so that will be considered now as E. And after that we'll go for inverse fast Fourier transform of the E, so that we'll get that the filtered image at the output. And here we are considering that the absolute values. So here ABS is nothing but absolute values. So when you're going for the subplot, the two rows, two columns, and the first image is original image, and here the second image is HighPass filtered image, and third image is HighPass filtered mask, and fourth image is mask after FFT shift operation. So this is about that programming of that HighPass filter in MATLAB in frequency domain. And here this is the original image after applying that HighPass filter, so that this is the resultant image. So here the HighPass filter which is used for allowing that the high frequency components only, and it will stop that low frequency components. So by using this HighPass filter the edge details will be enhanced. So thank you very much for watching this video. To watch more videos, please subscribe to my channel OPENBOX Education.